G'day guys, Hills 20 here and welcome back to Marble Mountain. I hope you've been enjoying Sichuan Province over the last couple of weeks. It feels really good to be finally releasing that to you guys, so I hope you've been enjoying it. Today, we're going to be continuing work on the light rail network of Montana. Now, nothing here is totally set in stone. I'd say that the stations that we have right now are, but I do plan to update this network as we continue this series and also get a bit more input from you guys too. So first up, in the last episode, we worked on the Green Line, which stretched from Callaway Beach all the way into the heart of the city to Central Station. Today, we're going to be looking at the Blue Line and the Yellow Line, and we're going to be finishing the Blue Line in this episode, and the Yellow Line will be a little bit more of a work in progress. So the Blue Line is going to stretch from this unnamed beach suburb. This is going to be a bit of a Santa Monica, Venice Beach inspired builds, unnamed yet, I don't know what to call it yet, so let me know if you have any ideas. Pretty substantial station, and this is going to be the starting point for the Blue Line. It's then going to stretch over to the Industrial Park Stockton, not much of a station, just a bit of a stop as it stretches its way into the city. The next station is going to be the bus terminal. Now this is going to be a pretty busy bus and rail hub where I think there's going to be quite a lot of people entering and leaving the city. I'm not going to build it in this episode, I'm just going to put down the bare bones and we'll get to it at another stage. As we stretch closer to the city, we're going to be stopping at Spartan Stadium and the Entertainment Center. Again, fairly busy terminal, and I really like the detail work on I do on this one. The Blue Line will then connect up to Museum, which is also a stop for the Green Line, so there'll be an opportunity for people to switch lines. The line will then go onto the boardwalk. This will stop at the piers, which I don't know what to call this stop either, so again, hit me up. Maybe something to do with the piers, something to do with the market, I don't really know. The second last stop will be Riverbank, which is a fairly touristic suburb, and there's also the ferry line here too. And then the last stop would be Bayview, which is where it terminates, and that's pretty much the Blue Line. Yellow Line's going to stretch from Central, it's then going to make its way to this stop, which is, I think we're going to call it Hospital, but I don't really know, this is where the Montana Hospital is, but definitely a name would be fantastic. And that's all I have in mind for the Yellow Line. It's then going to stretch across the river, and obviously we need to develop this whole area over here, but the idea is that it stretches towards where the airport is going to sit, which is, I'm thinking around here, probably the best location for the airport. I'm not really sure if I want the Yellow Line to stretch all the way to the airport or whether it terminates somewhere and then you can grab a monorail to the airport. Still trying to figure out that whole network. Would love your input. Sort of why I've stopped thinking about it, because I kind of want you guys to help me out with that idea too. In future episodes, I will be building the tram depot here. I'm still trying to figure out how I'm going to do that, but I think that this is probably the best location as it can connect up to all the lines pretty easily, and it's also close to the Central Station, which I think will fit the scene pretty well. But in a nutshell, that's pretty much the light rail network for Montana. What do you think? It's definitely not the most realistic network, it's definitely not the best running network. In fact, the way that I designed it was purely based on visuals, so I knew that I wanted the light rail to run through the highway like it does on the Green Line. I really wanted it to be on the boardwalk. I wanted it to run next to the highway as well in some areas, and I wanted it all to connect up to the Central Station. And then I pretty much tried to structure it based on visual elements rather than practicality. So it actually doesn't hit the areas that it really should. You know, in terms of moving people and getting people to the most busiest areas or areas that make the most sense to have public transport, you know, like the university and the downtown, there's no network that really targets those areas very well, which is a bit of a shame, but at the same time, I really didn't go for, you know, building the light rail in that way. I really wanted it to do a lot of visual things rather than do some more realistic things. I was chatting to Besquikelhausen, who came up with this beautiful network that targeted all the like specific spots. He also gave like a rundown of how each of the networks interact with the environment and how it you know, has been working over time through history. I'm gonna leave up a picture of it here. he's come up with a really great and obviously way more realistic way for the light rail to run through the city. I tried to embed a bit of those lines within what I was already doing, but unfortunately I just couldn't make it happen, mostly because of the stations and the limited amount of assets that I'm working with. I found it really tricky to then change where some of those locations were, and I also tried to embed the orange line that he had because I thought that was a really cool idea, but just couldn't make it work. Also running on not a huge amount of time, so I just had to abandon that idea and I just went with my original structure, which again, not the most realistic, but I don't know. In my mind, it doesn't have to be a very realistic system and it doesn't have to be the most well-functioning system. I really just wanted those visual elements in, and they were the main priority. So I think I will probably end up putting in another line, maybe the red line that he suggested, in future episodes, but for now, this is the general gist of how it works. And I also think that when I started building this, I had in my mind to create a light rail network that was more reminiscent of the metro system of Los Angeles, which I've been told is really bad and people hate it, but I don't know, for some reason I really find it quite visually awesome. I don't know why, probably because I played a lot of Grand Theft Auto, or probably because I've been there a couple of times and it just, I don't know, it just feels like something that is quite interesting to me. So I always seem to take inspiration from that network. Somebody also said that it looks a lot like the BART network in San Francisco, which I actually didn't really even take inspiration from, but now that I look at it, it really does. So I want you to consider this more of a metro system rather than a light rail or tram network. And I guess like a lot of the trains run mostly on their own tracks rather than interacting with a, like down the middle of a road or something like that. Obviously there are some areas that there are light rail that does stretch along the road, but generally they're on their own track and they're doing their own thing. So that's the general gist of the light rail slash metro slash transport system in Montana. I probably will end up building another line at some point, and the yellow line is yet to be developed. So would love your input. If you have any ideas, hit me up on Discord, because I usually do quite a lot of interactions with people there, and we work on the wiki and maps and all that sort of good stuff too. So if you have any ideas, hit me up there, or the comment section down below is also a good spot too. So with all that said, the first station that I'm working on is this unnamed station, which is in this unnamed suburb. Again, I want it to be a little bit like Santa Monica or Venice Beach or somewhere along the coastline of Los Angeles. I have a bit of an idea of what I want this suburb to look like, but it's something that's a bit of a work in progress. And I thought I'd just start by detailing this little suburb, so this little train station and the parking lot around here, and we'll come back to this location in another point in time. I really love the way this thing turns out. I think the assets work really nicely, and if you can't tell, the train line actually goes underneath that building, does a full loop and then comes back to the station, and that way it almost looks like it terminates at this station and then starts its route back into the city, which is what I really wanted a lot of these train lines to do. So again, I am using a mix of vanilla assets and assets that I've downloaded from the workshop. There's not very many that I've downloaded from the workshop, but there are a couple that I'm using for nothing new, nothing different since the last episode. But I think what I have to work with works quite nicely. So I'm using these planters from the Park Life DLC, which a little bit too bright for my liking, but they do the trick. And I'm also working on a bit of a pedestrian crossing too, because there's going to be a fair bit of people walking around, a lot of tourists as well. This would be quite a touristic area. So you can imagine a lot of condos, a lot of people wandering around, a lot of shops, a lot of commercial. That's the sort of gist of this area, and I'm really looking forward to getting to this spot, but we're probably a little while away from getting around here. There's a few other projects that I want to work on before tackling this one, but for now, this station looks fairly decent. I really like how it turned out. Now, before I start working on the next station, let me quickly talk about the future of Marble Mountain, because I'm sure a few of you guys are a bit worried about what's going to happen now that my new series, Sichuan Province, is now upon us. Good news is that I am still so obsessed with Marble Mountain. I actually find it really hard to switch between the two, because when I'm working in Marble Mountain, I'm like totally obsessed. I can't stop working. And then I'm like, oh, I guess I better get to the Sichuan Province. And then I start working on Sichuan Province and I'm like, oh my god, I'm obsessed. I can't stop working on this one. I'm in this great position where I'm just obsessed with both my projects at the moment, and I really just can't stop working on it. And yeah, you should not be worried about the future of Marble Mountain, because it's totally on the forefront of my mind. And then with that being said, I am actually in the busiest time of my life right now, where I am currently moving house. I am just completely smashed at work at the moment, and I'm actually going to be overseas in a couple of weeks, so there's going to be about 3 weeks of me not being able to record any videos. So it kind of sounds like I might be slowing down, it might sound like there's going to be less videos. For some way or another, I have managed to do a fair bit of work. I have been focusing on my channel really hard, just not screwing around, not floating around in my cities. I pretty much open up my computer and I just work. And what that means is you're actually probably going to be getting more videos from me than ever. The way I'm going to structure it is I'm going to be releasing big episodes of Sichuan Province and Marble Mountain on Saturdays. And then during the week, there's going to be small episodes of Marble Mountain where I tackle more suburbs or expanding out the city in some way, or focusing on some areas outside the city. Small episodes that don't really require me having to think about the whole light rail network or how the port's going to look, or, you know, these massive projects which probably take more brain power than actually detailing and building. And obviously, Sichuan Province is a whole different ball game. It takes a lot to record those episodes, and a lot of brain power and a lot of work goes into them. So that's like a little bit different. Whereas Marble Mountain, I can actually just produce episodes a little bit faster, quite a bit faster than those episodes. That's the plan. You're going to be getting more videos, which is ridiculous. I don't know how long it's going to last for. At the moment, it's looking like about 5 weeks. I can produce 2 episodes a week. It might continue for a while, I don't know, but I am just really focused at the moment, and I'm just producing some videos quite easily and quite quickly. And that doesn't mean like everything's pre-recorded. It means that the way that I'm structuring it means that I can release stuff and then wait for your input, and then release other stuff and wait for your input, so that I can actually produce things and collaborate with you guys just as much. And speaking of collaborating, the Marble Mountain Wiki is actually just exploding at the moment. People are putting so much into it, and I really love it, because I want this whole province to be more than just me building. I want your input. I want you guys to come up with the stories behind it. So go and check out the wiki if you haven't checked it out already. All right, we've just zoomed past a couple of stations. We just zoomed past the Stockton station, which I didn't detail. I just left it raw because we'll be coming back to that station at another point in time, detailing it and really making that area a bit better. We also zoomed past the bus terminal, which again, I'm going to focus a whole episode on that one. But I just wanted to get down the general idea of where I want things to sit. And we'll come back to that in another episode. This station is the Spartan Stadium and the Entertainment Center. And this station is a bit more prominent, and I detail a fair bit. So, to tackle such a huge amount of people coming to the stadium and the Entertainment Center, I probably should be building a station that is a bit bigger. But given the space, this is pretty much the best I could do. We do have an entertainment center. I didn't build it. That was actually built by one of my patrons. If you don't know, I invite my patrons in to build in my episodes every now and again. And someone built an entertainment center that went next to the stadium. He did an amazing job, so thank you so much for that. Now we're working on another station. This is the museum station. And I said in the last episode that I will probably update this at some stage. I haven't I'm not like totally thrilled with the work I've done on this, but I think it just needs a few, I don't know, needs a bit of an update. It's not that great. But regardless, this is a spot where you can change lines if you want to change onto the green line and make your way into a central station, then you can do that. There's also another point where when the yellow line goes over the bridge and it intersects with the blue line, and there could be another station there, but I didn't really do anything with it at this stage. I just thought I'd just leave it. And if you guys think that might make a good spot for an interchange or to change lines, then maybe, maybe we should do that. So now I am working on the boardwalk, and this particular line I really struggled with. I didn't expect to, but this was really hard. I actually spent most of my time trying to figure out how to make this work. And the problem that I had with it was I originally had created this train line by dragging this light rail down the center of this medium strip, and that was already pretty tricky when I did that originally had this train line here. And I also had this pedestrian path, this I believe it's from the amusement park footpath, and that was really cool because it just made like a different color and it made it like a bit of a tiled train line, which I really liked. The only problem with that is that people were using it as a walkway, which looked a little bit strange when you had a train coming down the center of it and all these people in the way. So I decided that to make it a bit more realistic, I had to get rid of that, and I ended up having to grab a new road to do this one, because basically I couldn't make it connect up to this train line and then through this onto this new medium strip. It was so tricky. I tried so many different ways. There's so much deleted footage, but this is pretty much the only way I could make it work. So unfortunately, it doesn't look quite as custom as it used to, but it does look a hell of a lot more realistic, and also the intersections work much better. So this is a much better looking train line. And I also wanted to put a little bit of detail work onto the actual platform. So again, just using the garden beds to just create a little bit more of a nicer looking platform. This area is very touristic, and there's quite a little bit of money gone into this from to this area by the government. So I wanted this area to look fairly nice. And the really cool thing about it is that you end up seeing a fair bit of people using this this station, because it is fairly close to a lot of main areas in Montana. So we've got the piers here, which a lot of people do visit, and you've also got the marketplace too. So I still don't really know what name to give this station. I really would like it to have something to do with the piers or like the markets that are really close by, but open to suggestions. The light rail then stretches across this boardwalk along the riverside and makes its way to Riverbank, which Riverbank, if you don't remember me building, I built a while back. This is a suburb that is pretty touristic. There is the ferry terminal here, which will also be connected up to the other side of the river. And I'm contemplating even connecting it up to that headland that we built a couple of episodes ago, where the toll booth is. I'm actually pretty keen to have like a bit of an extensive ferry network, and I don't know, maybe even connecting all the way up to Copper Falls, but we'll talk about that a little later. But I figured this would make a pretty good stop for the light rail, so pretty good connection for tourists if they want to get around the city, because stretches all the way to the beach and then also comes into the pretty much down to the downtown, which is a pretty decent connection. And finally, the last stop for this station, for this train line I should say, is the Bayview terminal, which I'm gonna be I've pretty much just copied over the same platform and idea as the one that is on the other side of this network, because I do really like it, and I can just make some little modifications and it's still quite unique. But generally stations do end up being pretty similar all the way along the network, and I figured if I just do a couple of little differences, then it still makes it fairly unique. But doing the same technique underground, do a bit of a loop and then place a building that covers it. That works really well. It's actually something that I really wish I'd discovered a long time ago, because I think that works so beautifully. Obviously, you do see a train go down there every now and again, but it's not too bad. By the way, I recently asked on Twitter any suggestions for some different types of vehicles, and a lot of people said that they were happy for me to try out a different type of vehicle, because like I said, I did want to have a light rail system that was a little bit more like a metro. So I ended up downloading I can't remember who designed it or what it is, but yeah, it's a different type of train, which is a little bit more like the metro, or you know, kind of a bit more reminiscent of BART, I guess, and a little bit less like a tram line or a light rail. But do let me know. I am open to suggestions, and if anyone is interested in creating a custom one for me, or even creating some custom skins, that would be awesome. And now I'm finally working on the yellow line, which only has at this stage two stops, that being Central and then this unnamed one. This is opposite Montana Hospital, a fairly decent hospital that I built when I built the downtown. I don't really know what I'm going to call this station. I feel like it should be called something Street or something Avenue. So again, hit me up in the comments and we will name it. But that is pretty much it for this episode. I hope you've enjoyed it. I've really enjoyed putting together this one. And do let me know what you think of this network. Obviously, it's not the greatest and the best, but I think I think it does a good job at showing off some really cool locations and some cool visuals in terms of where the light rail runs and where it runs to. Definitely go and check out the wiki if you haven't checked it out already. The Marble Mountain Wiki is growing bigger and bigger every day, which is awesome. And the Discord's a great place to get started if you're interested in joining in on that. But until next time, have a great week, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.